What happens after you lose weight? The dangerous 20. I'm gonna explain to you guys what the dangerous 20 is today. What's up guys? It's Anthony from AB Fitness Center, where we help you to lose body fat, gain muscle, and get stronger. Today, we're really gonna be talking about what happens after you lose weight and what the dangerous 20 is and why you need to watch out for it. But before we get started, I want you to hit that subscribe button. This way you never, ever, ever miss a beat and you get real life applicable fitness information right away without the fluff. Also, if you're not already, be sure you're following me on Instagram at abfitness. And if you have a question, please just drop me a message. I'll be happy to answer your question because I'm the people's trainer and I'm here to help you. Also, make sure you do that thing for YouTube where you hit that like button, okay? It really helps me out. It lets me know that I'm doing a good job. And it tells YouTube that I'm doing a good job too, okay? Make sure you also comment below and let me know if this, what I'm about to tell you, has applied to you. So let's get started. What happens if you lose weight? So you go on a diet, whatever it is, you go on something, you lose 20 pounds, what happens next, right? So I like to call that first 20 pounds the dangerous 20, because once you lose that weight, what starts to happen? You start getting more compliments from people, okay? People start noticing, you start noticing, your clothes start fitting bigger, right? You start noticing, you start feeling yourself a little bit. You're like, you know, I look good, my efforts are paying off. And this is why it's the dangerous 20. All right, so when that happens, mentally, a switch goes off. And you start to, instead of slamming on the gas pedal, you start to loosen up. And that's why it's dangerous. Because you start to slack a little bit. You take your foot off the gas. Maybe you stop weighing your food. Maybe you stop logging. Or maybe you just log Monday through Friday and you kind of skip the weekend. You know, that maybe a little bit more condiments, a little bit more, little here, a little taste there. You know, you go to your friend and then your friend says, you look great, you can eat this. And then you just slide it onto your plate. And you turn around and blink and that 20 that you lost has now become back to neutral plus 5. That's why it's the dangerous 20. So the dangerous 20 is when you lose weight and you don't end up keeping it off and putting that weight back on because you start to get comfortable. So what I'm gonna tell you and I'm here to remind you is you can't get comfortable with any of this, okay? Even if you hit your goal weight. So it's a perfect example. Let's say you tried to get in good shape for a wedding, okay? I'm just throwing a wedding out there, but just to say it's a wedding. Okay, so now you do really good up until the wedding. You have so much willpower. The wedding comes and boom, right after the wedding, you lose all your willpower and motivation. It's the same thing for me. Like when I competed in bodybuilding, it was like, okay, I have the desire to be 100% on point, meticulous with everything until I got to the stage. And then post stage, everything else, you know, and this is common amongst like competitors, is that after a show they put on, you know, anywhere between 10 and 15 pounds within that first weekend. It's totally normal because now they don't have that date in the back of their mind and they just kind of go back to neutral and they let off the gas. And again, everything has its time and place, but a smarter approach to it is going into all of this with the mindset of saying, okay, my goal is to keep this fat off and to not go backwards. So even when you do lose that initial 20 pounds and you start feeling yourself and you start feeling good, you know, you still don't let off the gas because you're not at your goal yet. And then if you are at your goal, then you have to take some time to rebuild your metabolism back and slowly start to build things back up. Because if you don't take the time out to do that, you know, again, like I told you, you're going to end up back to square one and more. Like I said, typically people who hit that dangerous 20, they start feeling themselves, they start doing good, they end up being 25 pounds over where they were. And that's totally, totally common. So my solution to you is don't listen to people when they give you that, when they say that to you. Oh, you can have a little bit. It's okay. You've been working so hard, you can have all of it. And don't even get into the mentality of thinking that. You know, people think like that all the time. It's like, you're not a dog. You didn't just do something good and you earned a treat. This is why fitness, you have to look at it as it's a lifestyle, okay? There is no end date to it, okay? And just because you lost some body fat or you lost some weight, that's not the end of your journey. It's not like, oh, you know, now I'm at my goal weight, so okay, I just go back to normal. Because then you're gonna end up being right back that you're gonna end up being back to that, whatever that old weight was. And you don't want that. So you gotta be careful of the dangerous 20. So my message for you today is, if you have lost some weight and you start looking good and you're letting off the gas, check yourself right now. If you're, like I said, if you stopped weighing your food, if you've, you know, maybe only logged during the weekend, not on the weekends, you know, maybe a little bit more snacks here, there, you're picking more. Check yourself right now and say, okay, I gotta stop this behavior because I know I still gotta keep going. I still have more goals that I wanna hit, and rein it in. Rein it in, keep yourself on track, don't fall victim of the dangerous 20. So that's typically what happens when most people lose weight. So I want you to not be most people. I want you to be special, and I want you to be better than you were last time. And by listening to this video, you're gonna really understand, okay, now I've let off the gas a little bit, I gotta punch that gas pedal again because I gotta get to my goal. It's that important. All right, so hopefully this message today found you right where you needed to, because sometimes we just need to hear the things that we didn't want to hear. And sometimes you just need a slap on the wrist, maybe two, maybe three, maybe four slaps on the wrist to get yourself back on track. Because again, a little bit of progress, you don't want it to backslide and end up having no progress. So again, make sure you watch this video here and this video here, because they're gonna help you take yourself to the next level. And also in the comments below, I'm gonna drop a link to our private group and the blueprint to getting you to transform your body. All right, guys, I'll catch you on the next one. And make sure you share this with someone who's approaching that dangerous 20.